Here I lay, bone shattered, blood drained and splattered, and tons of debris laying on top of me. And as my body lays here lifeless, my soul is struggling to become free. You see, when I jumped out of that 87th floor window on a September 11th, holding the hand of one of my least favorite co-workers, who at that point I totally forgot that I could not stand. But we were forced to push our differences aside, because the only thing left to disagree upon was to die either on the inside or on the outside. So we took that 87th floor dive without a care, because we had better chances of surviving using that window than we had if we used those stairs. So on my way down, I took one last look at that New York City skyline, because deep down inside, I knew that was something I'd no longer see, unless my prayers were answered that this wouldn't be the end for me. And as I looked into the sky across the river, I noticed that it was a beautiful day. But as I looked up above me, on my way down, was a dark cloud of gray, raining fire and debris, and a thunderstorm of broken glass was pouring down on top of me. And all of a sudden, I looked across the Hudson and caught a quick glance of Lady Liberty with her torch in hand, held up high as if to say, keep hope alive and keep your head up high, because you're dying for your country, even though your country is not able to save your life. So on my way down, I accepted my fate and screamed out, I love you, before I entered my pearly gates. Yes, I shouted, I love you one last time to my family and friends. Cause even though my life's about to finish, my love for them will never end. And for those who can hear me within the sounds of my cries, I say to you, don't forget us and those who tried to save our lives. Please don't forget us and those who died trying to save our lives. Here I lay, bone shattered, blood drained and splattered, and tons of debris laying on top of me. And as my body lays here lifeless, my soul is struggling to become free.